Whoa, they wash their hands after they use the bathroom?
Yeah.
All the time?
Depends whether they're slobs or not.
Oh, okay. You gotta stop that behavior.
I have no control over this person, just a guess.
Say you think I'm made of money?
Yes.
What if all parents were in fact robots who served the Illuminati government to complete massive brain control of the population?
Mm-hmm.
And since they were robots, they literally were made of money? And I, by that I don't mean it costs money to make a robot, I mean they were a robot made out of $20 bills.
I stopped listening to you.
The plot, right?
Sort of.
So, it's like the military is testing out, this was made in like 1998 or something.
Mm-hmm.
And the military was testing out if women could serve in, I think in this case it was the Navy SEALs, but it's supposed to be, it's like if women can serve in like heavy duty combat situations.
Okay.
So the main character, is Demi Moore, and she is like an intelligence operator, like
okay.
she does military intelligence.
Mm-hmm.
Which I guess, I don't know, I'm really stupid, but like,
you're not stupid.
Okay. Based on the movie's logic, women had already been allowed in intelligence for a long time. In fact, I think my grandma on my mom's side worked in military intelligence. But anyways,
that's kind of awesome.
Yeah, but anyways, so like there's this like female senator or something, and she has to pick the one candidate to represent all potential women who will go through Navy SEAL training, because they're doing the test to see if they allow women in the military.
Yes. Okay.
So they choose the intelligence officer, who's Demi Moore. And what I found disturbing about the movie, and keep in mind this is only like 15 years ago, Demi Moore's character, like they give her separate barracks from the men.
Like all by herself?
Yeah, basically she has an entire barracks to herself for obvious reasons. and like through the dialogue you get the unspoken message that it's like, guess what, you're going to be sexually harassed nonstop, and I'm not going to do anything to stop it.
Okay.
Because you know, like, general military culture of, like...
Rape, yeah.
Not just rape, but, like, even among the men, like, if a man says another man is weak or calls him or whatever, like, you just have to take it because you're doing really macho stuff.
Yeah.
So, so, yeah, like, basically, it's like, and I guess this probably happened in real life with however it went down when they were getting women in the military,
mm-hmm.
but, like, she had to be 100% okay with, like, at least sexual harassment, if not.
That's pretty much what all women going into the military need to deal with.
No, but but it, you know, like, the idea of women having jobs that were traditionally for men,
mm-hmm.
there are a lot of jobs now, like I'm sure Wall Street or whatever, there's a lot of women there who won't take any of that, who won't allow any of that to go on from their male.
Yeah, and it's different in the army.
No, but I'm just saying, it's like, okay, sorry. It just...
Yeah, what are you just saying?
It's like, they just had to accept it.
Yeah, I don't understand why you're so surprised. Because, like, I'm not surprised because I know this already.
Okay. Disturbs me is because from, like, a civilian point of view, the best way you can further the cause of women is to not tolerate that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But in the military atmosphere, the best way, the character at least, could further the cause of, like, equality of, like, women being able to serve. The best way she could further the cause of equality was to completely allow herself to be sexually harassed.
Well, yeah. That's unfortunate, but yeah.
And of course, there's all the, like, physical training and that stuff, which, yeah, I'm stupid. I'm sorry.
You're not stupid, stop it.
Okay. Thank you.
Why am I dropping off a tomato at like I'm doing a drug deal?
You took a cab to drop off a tomato?
No, I drove around my bike.
Oh. This actually does look like a real drug deal.
I know.
Maybe they just can't like have drugs in the game, so they put a tomato or...
I don't know.
Is that a kid? Or like a teenager?
She's a young adult.
By the way, they're both cooks, so that's why they're both wearing like beanies. Their hair nets, I think.
Thank you. scientific concept that is viewed as fact is true without referring to science?
I do not know. Oh, you don't have an answer either?
No. I was just thinking, like, I said to you or someone, like, I think I said to someone that, like, scientifically, if we're evolved from, you don't even have to say monkeys, just, like, evolved from, like, hut dwellers and cave dwellers who hunted and gathered, like, that's the scientific assertion, right?
Yeah.
So, if the, scientifically, if that's how the male body was, according to science, designed to go hunt an animal and kill it, right? Would that be incorrect to say? According to, like...
It would be too narrow, but it would be incorrect.
Yeah. So, obviously, unless you're police or military or doing something illegal, the male body is not supposed to go out and hunt and kill in the city, right?
I suppose.
Even though scientifically we were evolved and we have not spent enough time away from the evolutionary state where the male, his role was to hunt and kill.
Okay.
Are you following what I'm saying?
Sort of.
So, in order to talk to, like, say, someone who is, like, deeply disturbed,
mm-hmm.
who was thinking about this concept that I just outlined, one method to, I don't know, it's like, what do? You convince him in a different, convince him that science isn't true, or like...
I tend not to try to convince them of anything. I tend to leave them alone because they're not going to listen.
But you understand the problem?
Yes. But it is one that I don't believe we have properly figured out yet.
Well, I think we must have figured it out pretty good, seeing how, like, I know there are, like, 50 murders a year in the city, but...
But generally, well...
Overall, men do not go out and hunt and kill within the city, as far as I know. And I think it might be subverted into different things, like consumerism.
Probably. And the fact that taking care of your... What all living things are designed to do is reproduce.
Yeah.
Killing dangerous animals used to be the best way for men to reproduce because A, the dangerous animals would not eat them, and B, they could be all like, look, I brought home meat.
So, do you think then that there's no evolutionary holdover within, like, psychology is both learned and internal. Is that true?
That's a big argument. Like, you keep on making these statements that you could literally argue for, like, 4 days straight about.
Yeah, I know.
So, and I don't want to argue for 4 days straight right now.
I know, but these are the things that trouble me sometimes.
I know, I'm sorry.
Acoustic.